just go ahead and talk about tonight's game. It just seemed like things got off to a fast start right off the bat. Just kept snowballing from there.
It did, you know, and we had two good weeks of practice, but I know after open week, either one or two things going to happen. You're either going to play really good or you're going to play like you hadn't played in a week, and that's what it kind of looked like. We threw a pick right off the get-go and set them up, and they did a good job in the first half. We're doing some things, a few wrinkles, but not bad. They just made some plays. And I think they scored the first two series on us, to tell you the truth. We ended up getting a field goal right there in the first half, and then we ended up muffing a punt, I think, and just kind of dominoed from there. But that's football, you know. Defensively, we didn't play as well as we needed to in the first half. Second half, I thought we did pretty good. We rose up to the challenge, but we couldn't get enough offense started. We were too far behind. We spotted them too much points. But hats off to them. They got some good players. Quarterback did a good job. Receivers played well, and their defense came to play. And we had our struggles, you know. Cody did some good things when he came in. He led us down the field for our only score. So we got to really evaluate what we're doing and who we're doing it with.
What was said at halftime to the team? Because you did come out in the second half and play better.
Well, I challenged all of them, you know. I told them, especially the defense, that we were doing things that were uncharacteristics of our defense. We wasn't playing a tight end vertical and just some different things, you know, for us and schematics that we just weren't playing well. We came out in the first, second half, and we held them to three and out, ended up getting a pick and set up a score for us, I think, a field goal or something. And we did some good things on defense in the second half. I think they had one score off of a turnover, but, you know, had our moments, but not enough against a team that can score points.
I know the, you know, last couple weeks after games, you just say, you know, hey, you get the win. Doesn't matter how pretty it is. I guess, just from my view, it seemed like it kind of came back to bite you a little bit as far as the offense not being able to produce. Just, I guess, how frustrating was that for you?
It's frustrating. It's more frustrating our defense didn't play well. You know, our defense, we said we're going to put W's and L's on our back, and basically we spotted them some points in the first half that we couldn't come back from. You know, probably two of those touchdowns were our fault on defense, wasn't offense. So when you look at the game, we had 17 points. You know, if we'd have done our part, game might have been a whole different thing. So we had our hand in a loss, in this loss as well, just like the BYU game, you know. So we didn't do things well enough tonight to win. Our special teams didn't create field position. We didn't have any returns. So we're just going to go back to work. And, you know, that's the beauty of football. Each week, you're judged at the end of Saturday. So, but we'll have a long week, especially having to talk to y'all four times from Monday through Thursday before I can forget this loss and try to get the next win. So I won't feel good till Saturday night after the win.
As far as you mentioned the punt returns, it seemed like there were some questionable decisions made in the punt return game. I guess, what did you say or what did the coaches say about that?
Well, Kyron dropped one, and after he dropped it, he lost a little confidence. And on the very next punt that they punted, we stopped him. He had a ball he should have fielded, and he didn't, and it rolled down to the goal line, and that really set up some bad field position for us for probably about three series. But he got spooked a little bit. But I went and talked to him and told him, I said, look, man, you better than that. You what we got. I got faith in you. I love you. And after that, he caught some balls, and he actually had a couple good punt returns at the end. I mean, nothing that, you know, ended up producing points, but he got spooked a little bit.
I guess what'd you say to the team after the game? Just kind of, just what'd you say to him?
You know, I chewed him on him a little bit harder at halftime. I did think we played with a lot of effort, especially on the defensive side in the second half. Offensively, did some good things, but we just spotted them too many points. So I talked to them about where we stand in the league. I want to let them know that we're still tied at the top, us and Incarnate Word and UCA. And the quicker we can shake this loss and move on to UCA, the better it's going to be. We got to correct our mistakes, of course, but I told them that Sam lost to Lamar. So there's a lot of football left in this conference. You know, we've got four games left. We got two at home and two on the road. So we need to try and get it done.
I guess I can't say nice, but does it give you a little, I guess, I don't know what word, but, you know, UIW lost a tough one last week, came back this week. Does it kind of give you some kind of, I can't figure the word, but for you guys to come back next week and kind of do the same thing against a good UCA team?
Yeah, well, people's got to stop stereotyping the names of schools with how good a football team they had or how bad from the year before, you know. Incarnate Word is not the same football team. You know, they are a lot better football team. They got the top offense in the conference. You know, I think we held them underneath 400 yards, which was 100 yards underneath their average. You know, Abilene beat Nichols last week. So Abilene's not the same team. So, you know, anybody can beat anybody in this league. Lamar beat Sam tonight. So what does that tell you? You know, it tells you there's a lot of parity in this conference. So a win is a win. They keep talking about signature wins. Hell, I wish we'd have won by 1 point tonight. That'd have been signature enough for me.